sin. The time has come. It is his last reign. He rides into Jerusalem, greeted by the jubilant crowd, knowing all the while what is waiting for him there.
He hears the cries of blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And every place he passes that day shows him why he has been born. And though he comes in a few more days,
he'll be crucified.
Crucified! Nothing will keep him.
Nothing will stop him.
Before it is finished.
He says, my house will be called a house of prayer, but you've made it a den of thieves. Jesus, the perfect sacrifice, will not allow the merchants to make a mockery of the sacrifices of the people who have come to offer. And seeing Jerusalem, Jesus weeps for the city and those who live there. Themselves in his teaching and become more determined than ever to get rid of him. Soon their plots will intersect with his divine mission.
There's so much to do before time is gone.
So much you go through,
yet my love is drawn to the cross.
The following day, Jesus is eating at a friend's home. A woman brings a jar of expensive perfume. And with great devotion, anoints Jesus with it, as if anointing him for his burial. At what must have been nearly the same moment, Judas meets with the chief priest and agrees to betray the Savior for 30 pieces of silver, the price of a slave. The stage is set. On Thursday, Peter and John make arrangements to celebrate Passover, unaware that soon, Jesus will become the Lamb that will take away their sins.
The upper room, the Passover meal, he offers the bread and the cup. And when he prays, it's heaven that hears, not my will, but thy will be done. In grief so deep and so hard to bear,
he waits as
the then without struggle,
for hesitation,
for grace and for mercy, for
night where he is taken from one illegal trial to another. he is sentenced to be crucified. Alone, he endures the cries of "Crucify him." Alone, he suffers a Roman scourging. Pilate orders the notice that proclaims the King of the Jews. He kneels to the beam that will hold him. To humiliate him even further, the soldiers put a purple robe on his wounded back and twist thorns into a painful crown.
The city of Jerusalem, the time was long ago. The people called him Jesus. The crime was a
lifeless body is buried in a borrowed tomb, for a heavy stone covers the opening, and Roman soldiers stand guard. His disciples grieve the loss of their master and friend, and the end of their hopes and dreams. Early on Sunday morning, several women go to the tomb to anoint his body. They arrive to find the stone rolled away and the Savior's body gone. Suddenly, two men appear and ask, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen." Most of whom are still living. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles, and last of all, he appeared to me. Yes, Jesus did what he promised. He died and rose to life again. He ascended to heaven and he lives today, seated at the right hand of the Father. What a Savior he is.
Praise and honor unto God.
sacrifice, our Redeemer, and our hope of eternal life. And one day, He will come again for those who have trusted in His death, burial, and resurrection. On that day, every knee will bow, and every tongue will confess that He is Lord, and He will be crowned King of Kings.